1A is it's that in between Division 1 and 2. Yeah, it's really called 1AA. That was a misprint on the thing. It's called 1AA. And what it is schools, for example, Hofstra, Lehigh, Appalachian State, they're all 1AA. They're good programs, they're good schools, they're just not D1, and probably the only thing that deciphers them from D1 is the amount of scholarships they're allowed. You know, certain schools have a latitude. You have to give, you're allowed a certain amount of scholarships. D1, I think, like, that's why, as we go on here in the presentation, there's X amount of scholarships allowed for all sports. That's why they had that Prop 8, and they had more girls' sports than men's sports, because there's more men on a football team, say, than the girls' field hockey team. Football team will have 250 kids on a team. They'll pay for 110 of them. They'll always have an extra 100. And they'll travel 55 if you play D1 football, for example. But they have to match the scholarships. In order to match the scholarships, they have other women's sports. But getting back to your question, so 1AA, they just don't have the program that a 1A program has. And they're only afforded X amount of scholarships. Obviously, it's going to be less than the 110 that Division I schools are. So here we are, back to official visits. Let's see. Okay. Official visits. I think I said this. The first day of college, university, paid visit. That can occur only after your first day of class as a high school senior. You're allotted 5 official visits to D1 and 2 schools, but no more than 1 to a single school, regardless of the number of sports you play. Visits may not exceed 2 days. Unofficial visits is a visit to a college university that you pay for. Unlike an official visit, there is no limit to the number of unofficial visits you can make before your senior year. Now, 1 and 2, again, hopefully all you guys have that luxury, or that, I shouldn't say luxury, have that problem. Pick them wisely. You got 5 schools. Ideally, you want to get a paid visit because you want to live it, you want to sleep it. And I recommend to all the players, stay overnight. If you really want to go to the school, stay overnight. Take advantage of the visit. Go in there. It looks pretty. It looks nice. Try to go during the day. See what happens during classroom, what's going on outside in the courtyard. You know, live it. Go there that night. See if you like the nightlife. You know, see if you like it. Redshirting. Redshirting allows a student athlete enrolled in a 4-year college to spread 4 years of eligibility over 5. In your redshirt year, you will not lose a year of eligibility. You may attend classes and practice with the team, but you can't compete in games. Yes and no. Redshirt year, yes, you can practice with the team and extend your year. There's one of a couple of reasons why you would redshirt. One, you get hurt. And hopefully you get hurt before you play a game, because if you play a game, and in some sports, lacrosse's example, you put that shirt on, you get hurt first quarter, you're done for that year. You used up your eligibility. And football and hoops, you can play up to 24 quarters or periods. So you could maybe, you could be a friend. I made the team as a true freshman, exceeded my 24 quarters because I played, but I maybe played one play a quarter because I was on the special teams my freshman year. So I couldn't redshirt. But if you don't play at all, you can use it. But you can still suit up in some sports. In some sports, you can't suit up. And it also is up to the coach. Then the third reason is, coach says, you know what? I like you, but you're not going to make the team. So don't waste your year. We're going to redshirt you. And it tells you up front. And it kind of gets you ahead. And this can happen.
Is that a negative, coach?
That is not a negative. To an athlete, sometimes it is. Because they feel, hey, I'm not good enough. But I have to tell you, in D1, it's unheard of to make the teams a true freshman. When you see the kid from USC that starts at, you got a shot as a true freshman, it's a phenom. It doesn't happen. When I played, 3 of us made the team as a true freshman. Everybody else redshirted or didn't make the team. It's just Penn State, all these teams, probably 99% of the players redshirt. In lacrosse, some kids redshirt because maybe they're on a five-year academic plan, all right, and they want to use that redshirt year to help out with their education. They want to extend that year. Sometimes they want an additional degree or something like that. But that's how you do redshirting. And there's only really three, and the coach has a lot to say with it. You may just say you want a redshirt because you don't think you're going to start. Well, it's too bad. The coach has to say yes or no to that. So the coach plays a big role. NCAA gives the coach a lot of lead on that. You can get the information you need on recruiting scholarships and financial aid using the U Scout brand solution, and use it. Well, what am I going the wrong way?
You're going the right way.
I know. D1. There we go. All right, here we go. D1 member institutions to sponsor at least 7 sports for men and 7 for women, or 6 for men or 8 for women, with 2 team sports for each gender. Each player playing season has to be represented by each gender as well. There are contest and participant minimums for each sport, as well as scheduling criteria. Okay, this is just facts. Did I do that? I went to detail. Institutions, I'm sorry, I want to go back one. Yes. D1 requirements from high school, complete 16 core courses, 4 years English, 3 years math, 2 years science. You can read what the requirements are. However, schools, you know, have their own demands. They have their own latitude in addition to that. D2, similar things. The D2 institutions have sponsored at least 5 sports for men and women. They have their same requirements and criteria. They also have their core requirements that you need as far as your courses and your English and your math. However, each school can hold a different standard as far as, because D2, you have to have a 2.0 and you have to have an 820 and you have to have a 68 ACT, but the school you may want a 1200 and an 80.